y'all can nest double E. Cause I need your eyes on me. Once I get my feet in this end zone, no one can STOP. Can I make a scene like a movie, feeling big, keep it juicy before we start getting unruly. I've been hooping like a hoolie, keep it coolie before I stuff you in a locker like a bully. Like a bully. Put in the work, you can see my fingernail dirt. I'm the last one to leave, even when I come first. Yeah, you might want it bad, but I'm sure I want it worse. I'ma do it cause I love it, I'ma love it till it hurts. What's the worst that can happen, captain, I'm strapped in. No, I'm not crazy, I'm just tapped in. Hungry like a bastard, I'm about that action, no slacking. Well, I'm sorry, Miss Jackson. Cause sick of the pain, no one to call up for help. No one to blame but yourself. Had to come ring your bell. Like I need a ward, wait until I score. Make it rain till it pour. I'm a dog on fours, put in work like a chore. Till I'm underneath the floor, in the trenches like a war. If they wanna give them more, when I touch them. Touch them, touch them. I am not worried cause it is our time. I hear the crowd in the background, man. They...
Go! 60 Eagles! 60 Eagles! Ready? Count to 60. Count to 60. 18 rattling. 18 rattling.
Touchdown on the year as his guys are able to extend their lead. Extra point by Blankenship is up and good. And the lead grows to 10-0. So an early 10-0 lead for them now as they kick it away. And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully. The Titans offense set to begin the drive. And they're in an early hole. First drive, they threw the interception. That led to a touchdown. So a decent-sized deficit early on.
It is, but I think you hit the key words early on. So they have to decide, do we even need to change game plan? Or do we just need to execute better and try and get back in this game?
Now he's going to throw deep right side. He's got a man complete. And the tackle going to be made at the 38.
A lot of running backs in the passing game, they're just used to check it down to them or maybe dump off passes. This guy, they use him to stretch.
Second quarter now. Titans in possession of the football as they've got it with a first and 10. Willis will look to throw on first down. And that is incomplete.
Barton, I think he's got to be careful as he continues to try to extend plays because he's already been intercepted in this game. And the coverage, they continue to challenge all of his receivers downfield.
They try to throw on second down, but this one is incomplete.
They've given him some different looks here defensively in the early going. He's only hit two of his first five passes. With a big third down coming up, he's hoping he's got a play dialed up that can take advantage of whatever the defense throws at him.
And at the 7-yard line, the catch is made. And they do get him down, but not before he's able to slip it inside the 5-yard line. Henry is not going to get a whole lot, maybe a yard down to the 3. Only a yard that time, 2nd and goal.
You get down in this area of the field, you know you're going to get a heavy dose of number 22. They stopped him for a short game there, but can they do it a couple more times?
And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. A big play forthcoming. Here's 3rd and goal. Willis on 3rd and goal. And that's knocked away and incomplete.
That's a really nice job there by the coverage, understanding that they're in a high-stakes situation. If he doesn't make the play on that ball, there's an excellent chance it ends up either as a touchdown or as a nice gain downfield.
Matt Gay now gets ready for the field goal try. This is a fairly straightforward 22-yard short attempt. And Gay knocks this one through. So a long drive gets him down inside the 5, but ultimately they settle for just the field goal.
And I have to think that if maybe they were a yard closer, that would have made their decision tougher, and I think they likely would have gone for it. But in this situation, they just decided to take the 3, and I think it was a smart move.
And no thought of a return here for Hines. The Indy offense at the line and set to go. And that last drive was very, very balanced, pretty methodical. You think they go that route again?
I'm always of the school that until they stop me from doing something, I'm going to continue. And I think that that's exactly what they'll look to do. But the beauty is the balance that they've created sets up opportunities for big plays. Looks like a run, turn into a play action, and throw one deep.
Here's a pass swung out left to his running back. And they work this well upfield across the 45. That one good for 26 and a first down.
A lot of times the key is just get him the ball and let him do his thing. And they got it out to him on the left side, and he did exactly that. Excellent run after the catch.
Up the middle, here's Taylor. And the big boys up front, they're going to stop him right at the line. Call it no gain on the play, and it'll be 2nd down. Maybe I'm wrong, but it looked like even if he had opted to keep that, I don't think there was going to be much to gain.
Seemed like it was perfectly defense. And know what they say, those guys on the other side, they get paid too.
A throw there, but that's going to wind up incomplete.
I think he had to unload that one before he wanted to. He was right up in his grill. I think he was a dentist there without a license, don't you?
Just not enough time for the play to develop. Just lucky it wasn't a fumble, really. He finds Pierce. It's complete. And he's going to have another first down as the tackle is made at the Titans 36. Another good reception there. The Colts on the march. So operating from Tennessee territory now. Here's 1st and 10 at the 36. Going to run in the jet sweep with Jones. Room here to run. And he'll get into the end zone. Touchdown, Indianapolis. Marvin Jones, his 4th touchdown on the year. And the Colts have taken a 2-touchdown lead now. Extra point by Blankenship is up and good. And the lead is now 17-3. So after the touchdown, here's Blankenship kicking off. And we'll see a return here from the end zone. And the decision to bring it out, not a good one, as he's tackled at the 15. The Titans offense set to begin the drive. Their yard drive last time. It stalled out. They were forced to take the short field goal.
And the key phrase, you nailed it. Forced to, because you know coaches look at these short field goals.
He's got a man complete. And he's going to be taken down just shy of the 35. And we've hit the two-minute mark in this first half of action.
A reminder, once we hit halftime, as we do all season, we'll send it down to Jonathan Coachman in Orlando. He'll have all the stats and scores from games in progress around the NFL.
The best multitasker in the business, the coach.
And now a throw on first down there, but it's incomplete. After the incomplete pass here now is second and 10. Willis looks to pass it here. And it's a Titans touchdown. Traylon Burks, 36 yards. And the Titans have got it back to within a score. Extra point by Gay is up and good. And that slices the lead down to 17-10. After the touchdown, it's Gay to kick this one away. Opting not to risk it, and this will come out to the 25. The Colts come to the line ready to start their next drive. They have to be pleased with the way that they've moved the football thus far.
And why wouldn't they be? Two touchdowns on a field goal in their first three possessions. They're playing so well right now, the field goal probably feels like a disappointment.
Call it a full 3 yards in the wrong direction there. Brings up second down. The defense was ready for the run pass option. Diagnosed it perfectly.
Not only did they stack him up at the point of attack, but he was met by a host of light-colored jerseys.
And that is intercepted. Or was it? Wait, they'll say no. No interception. He did not keep the feet in bounds, apparently. So that's just going to be an incompletion. An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. From the gun, it's Taylor. And boy, he is very close to a first down, but from where they're spotting that football, he's going to be a foot or so short. It's a pickup of 13, but they're still a bit short, and it'll be fourth down. They're indeed going for it as they look to throw. He's going to have his running back. It's complete. And he'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds. They only needed a few inches, but still some anxious moments there. But they do convert on fourth. On first down, he'll drop to throw. And that one drops down incomplete. Good coverage there. Forced the ball free, and it's second down.
One thing you hope to see out of a rookie tight end is a real concentration when the ball's in the air, and I'm not sure that he didn't, but he has to be prepared for people making a play on it when that ball's up for grabs.
On second down, it's Taylor. 57 yards rushing for him. That was his 10th carry of the ball game.
We both know it's difficult, but they've made it look effortless out there. Through the air, on the ground, they've moved the ball with relative ease.
On first down, Whitaker. He'll get this one to Pittman. And he's going to get this down near the 25. The Colts going to use the first of their timeouts as they get it right at the 32nd mark of this first half. Still a few inches short of a first down as they come up now on second down. On the option to give to Taylor here. Only a gain of a yard, but that's all they needed. Now another timeout called for by the offense. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head toward halftime.
Second and inches is oftentimes an invitation for an offense coordinator to take a big shot downfield because he feels like he can come back on third down and pick up the first down. But sometimes you just don't want to break tendency. Stay with what you are, stay with who you know, and go get the first down. That's exactly what they did.
That's good for 21 yards and a first down. Operating from the gun, Whitaker. And that is caught. Touchdown, Indianapolis. Jonathan Taylor. As the first half is winding down, and the Colts will extend their lead here just before halftime. Extra point by Blankenship is up and good, and the lead now up to 14. Not much time to speak of remaining in this first half as the kick's away. And here comes a return from a few steps into the end zone. And he's able to get this across the 20, but not by much, as he's marked down officially at the 21. The Titans offense set to begin the drive. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
Now a timeout taken. Perhaps a chance for one more quick play and then another timeout if they hurry. We'll see. He's going to take a shot at the end zone. Why not? And incomplete on the deep ball.
Partner, they've been aggressive airing it out all game long, and no better evidence than those last two snaps. They weren't going to beat this coverage, though, two plays in a row, and that one falls incomplete.
Last play of the half. Here's Willis. He's going to try and go deep again. And that's going to be incomplete. Good effort there, trying to take a shot, but it's third down. So we hit halftime here in Indianapolis with the Colts on top. As we'll head down to Orlando, that's where we find our man Jonathan Coachman at our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach, and we welcome you back now alongside Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gunn getting set for quarter number three here. The Titans going to get the ball to start the second half, and they trail here as we get back to it on EA Sports. They'll elect to bring it out here from the end zone. And only able to get this to the 19, so probably should have opted for the touchback. The Titans offense set to begin the drive. This offense, Charles, had a strong first half throwing the football, at least in terms of yardage, but that hasn't translated so far on the scoreboard as they begin the third quarter here, trailing and looking for a little momentum.
Yeah, you're right about that because, you know, let's face it, in the first half, most of their focus was in the passing game, and to their credit, resulted in a healthy amount of yardage. So I would think that at halftime, they're going to anticipate that defense.
And off to races down the right side. The 20. Touchdown, Titans. A big play there. 81 yards. And the Titans come right out of the locker room and score here in the opening minute of the third quarter. Extra point by Gay is up and good. And that cuts the lead to 24-17. Following the touchdown, here's Gay to kick it away. And no thought of a return here for Hines. The Indy offense at the line and set to go. But Charles, they still have the lead despite their defense giving up a touchdown on the previous possession. And even though they have that lead, it feels like a back-and-forth ball game where to try to get momentum back, maybe they need at least three here on this drive.
I think you're right about that, Brandon, because your game plan doesn't change. I do believe your urgency does because of the last score that went against your team. So what you want to do now is have your own drive and try and make sure that that momentum stays in your camp.
That'll wind up as a loss on the play, so now they're staring at a third down and 12. We'll see what they have drawn up here a little bit behind the line. 12 yards needed to gain a first down. And a throw for Pittman is intercepted. Picked off by Christian Fulton. And the Titans are going to take over a couple of yards shy of midfield. First and 10 now, Willis and the Titans. Just shy of midfield at the 48. He'll start with a give to Henry. And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. The opening play of the drive goes backwards. Now they'll come up on second and 12. Now we've got movement up front. I think this is going to be on the Titans. And that false start penalty certainly not helping their cause here. Second down and long. Now Willis. He's got his man. That's Woods on the out route. That'll go for a gain of 7. And that's going to set up a tough 3rd and 9. Third down, it's Willis. He's letting this one go for Fuller. And he knocks the ball away, and it falls incomplete.
I'm sure this isn't a novel thought, but maybe run some simpler routes instead of trying to get it all back in one shot. Defense certainly appears to be ready for him. Try and get it back little by little instead of in big chunks.
Here's Fuller with a catch. And they'll wind up getting this one all the way down inside the 20. Fourth down conversion plays, you usually think 1, 2, 3 yards, maybe 10. Not there. What a huge pickup as the sticks make a drastic shift forward. And they'll let the quarterback keep it here on first and 10. And he will be brought down at about the 6-yard line. That's over 40 yards of movement with those last two plays. They'll try and run for it with Henry. Powers through it. And give him 5 that time as they draw a bit closer here for a 2nd and goal.
It's largely been the air attack that's gotten them down here, but now is where you start to lean on that running game. That's a good pickup there on 1st and goal.
2nd and goal from the 1. Willis on the sneak. And just a short gain that time as they're able to get him down. 3rd and goal now, mere inches from Pater. Trying to punch it in with Henry. Well, they hit him in the backfield and he will not escape. And that is not going to get it done. Not at all what they envisioned on 3rd down, 3 yards in the wrong direction.
That was a huge play on 3rd down. So now what? Do you go for it? Do you trust your offense? Or do you want to put on your defense to try and get the ball back? Me? I'm going for it right here.
And it's caught in the end zone. Touchdown, Tennessee. Robert Tonyan from 4 yards out. And the Titans' decision to go for it pays off with 6 points. Extra point by Gay is up and good. And that will tie us at 24. Nothing separating these two sides. 24 all our score as he sends this one away. Nyheim Hines now out of his end zone. And they'll get him down right around the 25, actually the 26 officially, so a net gain of 1 there. The Colts come to the line ready to start their next drive. We got a brand new ball game, all even after that last touchdown, so every drive now becoming a little more critical here in the second half. They'll run with Taylor to begin the drive. And he'll push his way forward to about the 32. 83 yards rushing for him so far as his terrific season continues here.
They'd love to just strike back with a touchdown right here. And if it's a long play, so be it. But the main goal, get a couple of first downs. Run some plays, run some clock. Allow their defense to get a chance to catch their breath, settle down, and relax a little bit after they just gave up the score.
And this is going to be a Colts first down as he'll get this up to about the 42. He continues to be effective running the football, a big reason that they have the lead.
And I love one of the quotes that I read about him where he said of himself, "I love it when a team just hops on my back and I just carry them along."
Now this one complete downfield on the left side. Yeah, he'll be out just a yard or two shy of the 30. That'll be marked as a 27-yard pickup.
When you get a big tight end like this, sometimes it takes more than one man to bring him down. Oftentimes, your best bet, just jump on and hold on and wait for your teammates to arrive to help get him on the ground.
3 quarters in the books. Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on 1st and 10. In motion left here, one of their tight ends. Running straight ahead, Taylor. And he's got it down to the 28. Not a whole lot there. The defense was ready, it looked, for that run-pass option.
You get the sense that next time he has that opportunity, he may keep it himself and get to the perimeter. Probably owes his back a little bit of an apology on that one, huh?
The last run got 3. Now here's 2nd and 7. Operating from the gun, Whitaker. He completes it to Jones. And he's brought down here just outside of the 20. And incomplete, a drop there in the middle third of the field. That'll bring up second down.
I've become a firm believer over the years that many drops happen before the ball's even snapped. When you call a wide receiver screen, as we saw there, I know these guys really well. They're thinking about that play going to the end zone, and sometimes they forget to catch the football first.
Now a handoff. Taylor with it. 4 yards the gain, and it'll bring up a third down.
This has been an up and down, back and forth type of a game, hasn't it? Maybe this long drive could take a little bit of the wind out of their sails, kind of settle things down a little bit.
Now it's the backup, Newton. He's got his man. It's Pierce. And the Colts are going to have first and goal as they try to finish off this drive with 6 points. A field goal could get them the lead, but it might not be enough here as they come up on first and goal. They'll run here with Taylor. And he's going to press this one forward as they stop it right around the one. 5 yards, a good run there, and now second and goal.
That's a great run right there on first down. Didn't quite get into the end zone, but now you've set yourself up for at least 2, maybe 3 more shots from close range.
Looking to throw on second down. Whitaker. Now this will be swung out wide for Taylor. Touchdown! Jonathan Taylor. His third touchdown of the game, number 16 on the season. And the Colts answer back with a touchdown of their own to break our tie and take the lead here in the fourth. Extra point by Blankenship is up and good. They will take a 7-point lead. And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken. The Titans offense set to begin the drive. They now trail by 7 after that last touchdown here in the fourth quarter. What a big spot for this offense. See if they can and that's caught inside the 30. Touchdown, Titans. A nice throw there by the second-year quarterback.
And I don't believe that was the kind of play he would have made as a rookie, because usually your rookie season is a continuation of your college days. A lot of one read, and if you don't have it, you just take off and go. Now he's settled in the pocket a little bit more, reading the field and getting to a second and sometimes third progression. That was a nice play.
And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. They'll bring a tight end in motion left. They'll start this drive out on the ground. And he's got this almost to the 40 before going out. 119 yards rushing for him now as he has been tremendous all day long. So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. Again, it's Taylor. And nothing much materializing there on the first down run. He'll get a couple, and that's it.
I certainly know that I, for one, would not like to be on the other end of a tackle when this guy's coming at you full speed from a strong safety spot. Boy, that was a nice play.
Off the option, here's Taylor. And slow going there as he'll only get a yard, maybe, up to the 41.
And the big fella stuffed that one up in a big way. I think doubling him has to be a priority because you can't move up to the next level if you don't take care of him first.
The offense on third down, they've converted just 2 for 6 thus far. This is 3rd and 7. On the option to give to Taylor here. And he'll lose yardage here, back at the 41. That'll make it 4th down after a loss of 1.
Well, that was one of the few times they've been able to contain him thus far. He's over 100 yards for the game, but he lost a bit off his total on that carry.
And they'll send the tight end in motion left. On 4th down, Whitaker. And it's incomplete. They cannot convert, and they turn it over. The Colts Browns unable to convert here on fourth down.
And the Titans, they've got the football back, and they've got it in great field position. A first down carry for Henry.
Dio Odengbo there to make the play defensively.
I like the call there because that was one to take time off the clock and get them closer to getting out of here with a W. In the mind of the play caller, all you want to hear is tick, tick, tick.
On second down, here's a keeper by the QB.
And they'll have it in the red zone before he crosses over out of bounds. An excellent run of 22 yards on the keeper and also a first down. Inside handoff, Henry. And they corral him just a couple yards shy of the end zone. The Colts going to use the first of their timeouts as they get the stoppage with 65 seconds remaining. They keep it with Henry on first down. And he will take this one in for a Titans touchdown. Derrick Henry with career touchdown number 91. He joins a group that includes Tony Dorsett and Isaac Bruce, among others.
And the Titans have broken this deadlock and have taken the lead here in the fourth.
And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. The Indy offense at the line and set to go.
Well, Charles, you remember their last drive. They went for it on fourth down, didn't get it, but you understand why they did in this close game late. Now, though, the road back is even tougher.
Yeah, no doubt about it. And it was fair to look back and say the fourth down was the moment where this one was decided. But as you mentioned, understandable about why they went for it. But, hey, a lot of credit to the guys on the defensive side of the ball. They knew they'd have to defend in that situation, and they got it done.
Work with me, partner. Take a deep breath, because that's what they're doing down the field now. That incompletion allowed them to exhale a little bit. Get in the huddle, kind of scan the crowd, see if any celebrities are here. Relax a little bit as they start this big drive.
Ready. So following the incompletion, here's second and 10 from the 25. They'll send a receiver in motion left.
20.
Here's Newton.
Now a desperation throw deep downfield. It's caught inside the 25. And yes, he's into the end zone. So they get the late score they needed. And now the extra point can tie this thing up in the final minute. Don't forget the extra point. It's up and good. And, partner, we've got a tie game here in the fourth. Set to go now with the kickoff. These two teams all even again as we continue in this wild fourth quarter. And with time a factor here late, he'll just take a knee and they'll start things out at the 25. The Titans offense set to begin the drive.
Well, partner, here it is. They've got the chance to win the game. You'd have to think they need to get it near the opposite 40 to have a chance to kick a game-winning field goal. We'll see what they can do.
And you're right about that, because if we look at it in macro, that's what it looks like. But I think in micro, the head coach has already asked the special teams coach, what is he feeling? What does he think? Where does he want the football? What's the yard line we have to get? And he's already relayed that to his quarterback and his offense. They know what the goal is. Now the key, can they get there?
The Titans going to use the first of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 21 seconds to go in the football game.
Here's Willis.
He's letting this one go for Fuller. And he's got it inside the 10. And he's in for the touchdown. Seconds. Forget overtime. They've just likely won this thing in regulation.
Extra point by Gay is up and good. And they will take a 7-point lead. After the touchdown, it's Gay to kick this one away. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. He'll start on the ground here on first down. And he'll be taken down as that'll net him only about a gain of 9. And a timeout is called. So now you're looking at probably just one final play from back in their own territory, and they're going to need a miracle. Maybe a good spot to take a shot. Here, second and a yard from the 34. They'll bring a receiver in motion left.
Good. Hey.
Throwing is Newton. He's going to let it fly. That's going to be knocked away and incomplete. So after all of this, it comes down to one final play.
And just think of what it's going to be, because from this distance, you've got to be prepared for everything. Hook and laterals, tip balls, you name it. A lot of laterals after a catch. Just got to be prepared, stay on your feet defensively, and tackle someone.
They'll try and run for the first with Taylor. A fun, close ball game comes to an end. On that last play, Charles, they were on the wrong side of midfield. They needed something near a miracle, and they couldn't get it done.
Yeah, the effort, that was good. Very good, in fact. They were just a little too far out to get a decent look at the end zone for that last opportunity. Couldn't get it done, but a nice game overall.
So for the Titans, they continue to put themselves in position for a first-round bye as they move to 8-2. And they'll return home next week to take on the Kansas City Chiefs.
Got so many memories that I made on Casket Road. I done gained the world, I ain't never sell my soul. This is God-given, so I thank him as I go. Hate to sound conceited, but I know. Crazy thing they with me. Yeah, crazy thing they with. Run up on me, baby, so you gon' see. Yeah, God power from my head and my feet. Yeah, this colossal, what I say is gospel. I cook this with love, they gon' eat it up and swallow me. I'm from the ghetto, baby. Seen bodies in the street before I could tweet. I came from nothing. I turned a mustard seed into a million in the discussion. Had a TED talk with the higher me, show me how to run it up. I need all my cheese. Every day that I wake up, I'm pinching myself. Can't believe that I'm really me. Popping shows in New Zealand, boy, you is not eating, man. We do not play in the same league. I gave my mama some racks and she asked me if I'm selling. I said, mama, please. If I was, do you think I'd let you know? Got so many memories that I made on Cascade Road. This is God-given, so I thank her as I go. This gon' sound conceited, but I know. Crazy thing they with me. Yeah, crazy thing they with me. Yeah, got power from my head to my feet. Yeah, run up on me, maybe so you gon' see.
Chase, I just attract what you put in, you get back. I'm screaming Campbell, then still hit the dance in them wherever I'm at. Feel like a champion, mama mentality. I am the masterpiece, life is the crap. Deep love me, and I can't.